But the standings might be slightly deceiving because he had to finish on Pommel Horse, typically the lowest scoring event. And the standings are all relative until everybody's done Pommel Horse, the lowest scoring event,
right,
and everybody's done Vault, the highest scoring event. The numbers are deceiving until those numbers are out. 16:05 for Fabian Hamboeken. He is currently first in the all-around, but we are not done with the final rotation. Nice.
And like you were saying, Bart, I wish that wasn't the case with these events. I wish they were more evenly distributed. You know, to have an event Pommel Horse, which is harder than the Vault in some cases.
I think that is another, to continue our discussion, a replication of the current rules, because when there was a ceiling of perfect 10, every score, every routine had essentially the same value to
right.
an all-around gymnast.
Right.
Now with an open-ended scoring system, so-called, although it's not completely open-ended, each event doesn't have the same relative value to an all-around score.
That's right.
One of the unfortunate things about this scoring system as it exists now. Nice.
Layout, Kovacs. Caught a little close. Coleman. Japanese really emphasize their execution during their release moves. You see their knees never come apart upon catching. Relatively good routine from Mizutori. Oh.
Oh, you can't give up those landings.
Especially not in the last rotation. That deduction more than likely 4/10 because he took a small step and then a large step. So you take the 3/10 deduction and then a 1/10 deduction for the small step. Thought his skills could have finished a little bit more in a handstand. We'll see if that makes the difference in this routine or not. Elements like that, he finished near horizontal. Judges want to see you finish as close to the handstand as possible, maybe a 15 degree margin there.
There's certainly a lot of respect
absolutely
in this gym for the quality of the gymnastics we're seeing.
And that's what I love about this sport is on the floor there's so much camaraderie and so much respect. We know how all the gymnasts, no matter where you're from, we all know how difficult this is.
Kim Dae-young 14.5, substantially higher than his qualifying score, currently second in the all-around. But some of the best yet to go. Mizutori 14.95, about a half a point lower than his qualifying score, and much of that, as you mentioned, in the landing.
In the landing of that dismount. A little bit of pike down as well.
You see there, folks, Tomita needs a 16.025. to go into the lead. Hard to believe after the start that he had that he has a legitimate chance at not only going into the lead but into a medal position. Now he scored only a 15.3 in the qualifying round. He's a good score on high bar. A score of 16 on high bar is pretty unlikely.
Pretty hard to do. The only person that has capability of doing that is Hamboeken of Germany. But nonetheless, this is a good routine for him. He's very, very clean. Just looks as if he has so much control on this. Oh!
Oh my goodness!
He rarely misses that. In fact, I have not seen him miss that in competition.
Well, he missed last year at the World Championships on the high bar. Yang Tae-yung looking on.
And that's just unfortunate. He was right there.
Oh! And he was fifth in the all-around. Coming into this rotation, after a shaky start, he got it going again and looked to be a medal contender. Well, that is unlikely now.
Oh. I think he's just fighting through this competition now. Still has event finals coming up in a few days as well. That's a nice looking layout double-double dismount. He's a very technically precise gymnast. Much respect though, buddy. This is not easy. There's that element there. It's called a Coleman.
What do you think happened?
Just now he was going right here. Well, that element, the Coleman, a lot is dependent on how you set up the giant beforehand. You have to be so precise where you kick and release the bar. Probably kicked a little bit late on that and just inches off.
Tomita turns 27 in November. He'll go back home to Tokyo and get back to work. No question that this is a disappointment for him, the former world all-around champion, and he gave way to Yang Wei, who won the last year's world championship. He'll have to regroup and get focused for next year's Olympics.
And the champion is doing it again. As easy as you like. Good battle for second and third. And fourth. But it is Phelps. Lofty second. Moving through Marin in third place ahead of Maluli. Well under world record pace at the 350. He's going to do it again. Superman. On his way home. Michael Phelps. In the 400 individual medley. He has slaughtered the world record line here. Phelps, a smooth, rhythmical stroke. The Baltimore Bullet does it again. It's number seven. And a world record. Phelps, the magician. Superman does it again.
A single line, etched into space and time, is limitless to some. But to others, it's the edge. Go! WCSN embraces its wild side with athletes willing to put it all on the line for the gold. If you spin it, flip it, jump it, grind it, you'll find it all lands here on WCSN. The Edge. Stay on or falter. WCSN.com brings you the countdown to Beijing.
What a performance there.
It's going to be too close to call.
And she does it.
Watch World Championships.
Unbelievable stuff here at the World Championships.
Be a part of every world record.
The new world record for the Americans.
Watch your favorite champions win medals daily. Only at WCSN.com.
Here comes Blago on the outside. And it's a knockdown, drag-out fight between best friends for a world championship title. An unbelievable development, and there goes Blago, past ankle. It's absolute mayhem in the stadium as two Germans sprinted out for the world championship victory. It will be Andrea Henkel, world champion for Germany, ahead of her teammate Martina Blago. Henkel gold, Blago silver, Wilhelm the bronze.
WCSN brings you another defining moment from the championship corners.
And now we move to the fastest man on snow. It's American Bodie Miller. He's tearing up this course here in Hinterstoder. They scream for Bodie at the bottom, and the American, who's been blazing by the entire field, is in the first place by a huge margin, almost 8-tenths of a second here in Austria today. When he is on, he can't be beat.
Still waiting for the score of Hiroyuki Tomita after that disappointment on the high bar. He doesn't show a lot of emotion even when he's winning. He's a pretty cool character. But there is a resignation in his face that he was fifth going into the final rotation. These medals are surely up for grabs. Certainly the silver and bronze are. And that's not what he had hoped for.
Still a respectable gymnast. Will not be forgotten about going into next year's Olympics. Always a player in the all-around. And a heavy contributor to the Japanese team.
Yang Wei getting set to go. He is currently the Superman of gymnastics and has a shot at history here to be the first back-to-back world all-around champion in the history of men's gymnastics. Tomita's 13.975 drops him at this point from fifth to ninth and likely to drop further.
Looks so calm on the exterior, but read into him a little bit. He's very excited.
Of course, China, if they have one weakness as a team, it's here on the high bar.
And you can see it a little bit in his execution. Pay attention to his lower torso.
Mm-hmm. Oh, no!
Oh, no.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow. And I spoke too soon.
Oh! My goodness. Luckily, he's okay. Obviously, big deductions. Does he still have a big enough lead to manage to hold on to the gold medal position with a disastrous fall like that? Probably so.
Probably.
Wow. Now, that's not uncommon with those moves.
It's
not. Pirouetting skills. If you don't get your hand on, it's see you later.
It's pretty much see you later. Some gymnasts can hang on and twist around and pull themselves back up into a free hip. Notice how the Chinese coach, they really tend to overspot these full twisting elements or full pirouetting elements.
And ironically, he's standing right under there, but missed him when he did fly off.
Right.
I don't think the coach can really do anything
for
him. There's no way you can catch you. You go by so fast.
I honestly think it's more of a comfort factor for the gymnasts.
But it does expose that they are vulnerable on the high bar. Okay, this wasn't the way he had anticipated wrapping up this competition, no question. Fabian Hambuchen started off a little weak today, but he has worked his way up and finished with a big high bar routine. He will be a medalist today, there's no question about it. Does Yang Wei's score hold up? Let's calculate the deductions there. It's a half a point for falling.
Well,
some technical, eight-tenths for falling,
excuse me. And then he was very loose going into that skill.
Form errors,
technical errors. He won't get credit for that skill. Luckily, he fulfilled all his category requirements, so missing that skill won't hurt him in terms of fulfilling the requirements. Layman's terms, he really didn't need that skill. So if you eliminate that skill out of his routine, all you're really looking at is deductions.
He needs a 12.15 to maintain the lead.
I think he'll be able to pull that off.
No question about it. Now here's where it goes down to start values. He came into this competition with a substantial benefit because he has such high start values that he could afford a mistake.
That's right. It's kind of nice to have.
We didn't expect
policy,
we'd see the mistake.
Right? No. Yeah. It's nice, it's got to be a good feeling for him knowing that he has that insurance policy. It'll be interesting to see next year if something like that were to happen. Could another gymnast actually surpass him? Had this been earlier in the competition, could have dramatically changed the outcome as well.
39.7 is his total start value, which is substantially higher than the rest of the field. So based on the quality of his gymnastics and the mastery of his gymnastics, he does buy himself some room for a mistake, but we didn't expect we'd see it.
No, I really didn't. I thought he was very calm and collected. However, these skills could have had nothing to do with his preparation whatsoever. Sometimes your hand just slips.
13-6.
Got it.
So by more than a point, nearly a point and a half.
That's incredible.
He will hold on to his lead and become the first male gymnast to win back-to-back all-around titles in the history of the World Gymnastics Championships.
Congratulations.
Let's go back to 1954. Fabian Hamboeken acknowledges Yang Wei's superiority. Fabian will finish in the medals. Liang Fuliang and others congratulate him on what was a really kind of strange day of gymnastics.
It was. It was very strange.
Start to finish.
Especially towards the end of the competition. I mean, the turn of events, the re-ranking of gymnasts.
Be very interested to see here in the final rotation, lots of juggling of the standings. Remember, coming into this rotation, it was Yang Wei, Kim Dae-jung, Liang Fuliang, Mizutori Tomita, Fabian Hamboeken was tied for sixth with Yan Tae-jung, but Hamboeken will work his way up onto the podium. Anton Fokin of Uzbekistan was in eighth. Jonathan Horton from the United States in 10th.
Here you go. You get a little recap.
Nice double-double. Now, Jonathan Horton, here's how the shuffling of this final rotation is pretty dramatic. Horton in 10th place, but he could earn himself a medal with a 15.85. On floor, which is, now that's a high score for floor.
That's a high score, but
this is a great event.
This is a great event for him. And in fact, 15.8, that would probably be one of his personal best on this event. Doable, yes. We'll see if it happens. I know he can come very close to that score. Full in dismount with a small hop.
15.625.
So close.
Not enough. So Horton will come incredibly close to a medal.
Got a taste of it.
On this unusual day of gymnastics, fourth place will...
less than 0.2 out of a medal.
...be the place for Horton. So there it is. And look at that. Yan Wei holds on. Fabian Hamboeken will get the silver. Hisashi Mizutori from Japan, the bronze, and Horton, by 0.2 of a point, finishes just out of the medals. Anton Fokin of Uzbekistan dropped from 8th to 16th. David Durrani from the United States will finish in 17th place, which is exactly where he was coming into the final rotation. Hard to believe the juggling of the standings in the sixth and final rotation. Fabian Hamboeken, to go with his bronze medal in the team competition with his German teammates, will earn a silver medal in the all-around. And when you're going up against Yang Wei, a silver medal is as good as gold, because Yang Wei is...
it absolutely is.
...solidly a favorite. Hamboeken, on a strange day of gymnastics, manages to pull off a silver medal.
That's right, and didn't even have his best meet, and you see where he ended up. He's definitely going to be a player in next year's Olympic Games. And Yang Wei knows it. He can't afford too many errors like that. And got away with this one.
He did, because the field was decimated in many ways. His
right.
strongest competitor, Tomita, was not on.
Right.
So others took advantage of this rather weak field, in fact, and lack of depth. There's really only about... 8 guys who could really win a medal. based on their complete mastery of gymnastics. And Jonathan Horton, member of the fourth place finishing U.S. team, a terrific improvement from their last year's 13th place, earns another fourth place, finishes out of the medals 2 days in a row.
And that, again, you know, just like their fourth place finish as a team for the U.S., to have an all-arounder that close to the podium, again, it's just very motivating for the entire delegation back here.
Well, it's hard to say. It was sort of an unusual day of gymnastics with some unexpected drama here at the end. I'm glad we got to discuss a lot of the issues about men's gymnastics these days and the current rules and quota points. And boy, did we get a flood of emails. I'm glad all of you sent us a note with your personal opinions about the state of gymnastics.
Probably talk more about it in a few of the other events if we have event finals to discuss more.
It'll be hard to shut us up, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
We'll be back with the results when we come back.
Championship Corner.
And here is the guy, the native of St. Anton, 27-year-old Mario Matz. The gold medal winner at the World Championships only has to preserve a lead of half a second here, and he will win his first World Cup slalom of the season. Last World Cup slalom, he was third in Schladming. After a pair of second-place finishes in Kitzbühel, and he has the lead at the split by a half second. Virtually the same margin he led by after the first run. Mario Matz winding his way to the finish line. The Austrian wins his first World Cup slalom this season by 0.4 of a second here in Garmisch-Partenkirchen.
Stopped! Got it!
Very explosive and very beautiful technique.
There it is! There it is!
Ricardo punches it off of Fabio and out of bounds.
Warren can still win with a point and he gets the takedown!
Picked up again. Phnom
Penh. Ah, what an angle for that one!
Oh, Fabrice, with that running attack. Just a great match.
Beautiful dismount with an awesome stick.
Fantastic.
Both players displaying their skills back from the table. Brilliant play from Wang Hao.
WCSN brings you another defining moment from the championship corner.
We are at the 2007 FINA World Championships with Kate Ziegler going for gold. Let's go poolside.
Look at the two leaders. They are fighting tooth and nail for the gold medal here. The white cap of Laure Manadou of France. The black cap of Kate Ziegler of the United States. She won't give up though, Ziegler. Will not give up at all. Manadou, the sprint from Ziegler. Ziegler it is, trying to get over the top. Manadou starting to tire now, and Ziegler it is who's finishing stronger. Ziegler, Manadou, stroke for stroke. Ziegler will get there. The United States win another gold medal. Ziegler, championship record. Manadou takes a silver in an epic encounter. They don't have to be short to be sensational. What a race.
Ready to take flight?
Pure poetry.
Wow. What a performance there.
Oh, they've got it.
That is the stadium record.
It's done.
One lap to go. Number one.
Their new world record for the Americans.
Look at that.
Getting set for the awards ceremony now here in the men's all-around competition. Day three of coverage here of the World Gymnastics Championships live from Stuttgart. A little bit later on, we're going to be having the women's all-around final. Looking forward to that competition. I expect it to be dramatic as well. For those of you watching at home, the women qualifiers, the top women qualifier from Romania, Steliana Nistor, and Nastia Liukin and Sean Johnson from the United States qualified second and third. The top three separated by just 0.4 of a point in the qualifying rounds. The reigning world champion Vanessa Ferrari qualified in fifth. So expect to see a thrilling competition in the women's all-around later today. And then two more days of coverage of individual apparatus finals. And we'll see a lot more from these three gentlemen in particular.
Siegerehrung. 40. NBB Turnweltmeisterschaft 2007 Stuttgart. Mehrkampffinale Männer.
40th NBB World Artistic Gymnastics Championships 2007 in Stuttgart.
Bart, what does this mean for the German? When was the last time that the Germans had a all-around player? Let alone an all-around medalist. It's been a while, hasn't it?
It has been a while. Let me think back to people like Andreas Wecker and others.
Ebenso 90,850 Punkte, Yang Fuliang, China. Siebter Platz, 90,875 Punkte, Flavio Scocci, Rumänien.
You see the acknowledgement of the rest of the field. Martinez was in sixth place from Spain, a consistent top tenner in the all-around.
Auf Rang 5 mit 91,05 aus Südkorea, Kim Dae-jung.
These guys look exhausted.
They do. Kim Dae-jung qualified only in 17th place into the final today. He had a shot at a medal, but finished on a weak event, typically a low-scoring event, the Palma Horse, and dropped to fifth place. Jonathan Horton qualified in ninth, ended up in fourth, had a very, very good competition, and this has to be big motivation for him to see and experience fourth place in the team competition, fourth place in the all-around competition. I got to believe that's going to add a little fuel to his intensity between now and the Olympics to see how close he was to potential medal.
I think it's going to this is going to be a good stepping stone for him going into next year. And he's a smart guy. He's definitely going to use this the right way and the right form of motivation to possibly get on that podium in Beijing. It's good to see him finally put it together, though. He's clearly the best U.S. all-arounder that we have right now.
From Japan, aus Japan.
A lot of people waiting to see what happens with Paul and Morgan Hamm. Paul Hamm, the reigning Olympic champion, at home calculating his...
Oh, yeah.
Will he be a factor? What do you think about Paul's chances? He certainly has the quality.
He does,
you know, gymnastics.
Just like these other top gymnasts, he's very technically sound. And talent comes second to his work ethic, which is impeccable. So as an all-around gymnast, I mean, Paul actually has been working on his routines and rings, which was probably his weakest point, and the last quad is actually not so much as a weak factor this time around. So he's very balanced. The floor finalist, so he's really good on floor, pommel horse, swings beautifully. Rings, I just mentioned, he's got a decent set to work with. vault.
World champion and winner of the gold
6'6"
medal.
Vault, more than likely.
P-bars
and high bar. Exceptional, so he's could give this guy a run for his money if he decides to go for it.
Paul Hamm, as you said, a very bright young man, and calculating his start values relative to Yang Wei's. Yang Wei had a big room for error coming into this competition because of the quality and the high level of difficulty in his routines that he can perform most often with consistency. Paul says he gives up a little bit to Yang Wei in terms of start value, but he hopes to contend with him in terms of execution.
Execution and consistency.
Consistency, right.
Paul's one of those guys that can go out there and rock six routines.
For the first place,
Yang Wei, as solidly as he is in first place, we saw his vulnerability on the high bar.
That's right.
Not only weak technique and not very high start value, but actually the ability to fall.
And not confident.
Not confident,
right.
With the coaches reaching in on every...
So
if there is one vulnerability for the Chinese team that can be exploited by their competitors, it would be there on the high bar. And in that case, you got to hand it to Paul Han.
Absolutely.
Who delivered a gut-wrenching routine in 2004 to nail that
storybook ending.
Olympic gold medal.
For the third place,
Helmut Rau, Minister für Kultus, Jugend und Sport in Baden-Württemberg.
So this is just the first half of our coverage today. The women's all-around final coming up. The Americans feature Nastia Liukin and Sean Johnson, who will figure prominently, hopefully, in that end result.
Be interesting to see what happens on the women's side, too, compared to the men. The Chinese have captured two gold medals out of the available two already.
Right. The American women won the team gold medal. China second, Romania third. We've talked all day long about the specialist aspect of gymnastics, particularly on the men's side. We'll be seeing demonstration of the best specialists in the world the next 2 days here on our coverage from WCSN as we focus on.
And it's important to note that Bart, we may not even see most of these competitors on any of those events in the event finals. That's just the nature of the sport, whereas in the past, the all-around champion, you would more than likely see make four, maybe five event finals. But given the nature of the sport now, guy that's third in the all-around or second in the all-around may not make any event finals.
I'm happy to see that they played the entire Chinese national anthem today. The other day in the women's team competition, they only played half of the American national anthem. Could it take a minute more just to finish the song? So I'm proud that probably somebody said, hey guys, just play the whole song. Give them the respect they deserve. There are the gold, silver, and bronze medalists, Yang Wei, Fabian Hambuchen, and Hisashi Mizutori. Unexpected drama in today's all-around competition.
Very much so.
Hambuchen, we'll see him again in the finals on the high bar where he's the top qualifier. Also on the vault. So he is not done, and he's had so far two bronze medals at these world championships in his home country.
I imagine a lot of ice baths tonight. Guys jumping in all the way up to their necks.
A lot of beat up gymnasts, there's no question about it. All right. We'll wrap up our coverage here and take a short break and get set for the women's all-around final. For all of you watching at home, please remember to tune in about an hour from now as we will get set to see who are the gold, silver, and bronze medalists in the women's most coveted individual award, the gold medal in the all-around. Hey, Raj, happy birthday to you, my friend.
Thanks
for joining
us. Bart.
Set. Destination?